Okay, welcome, boxing fans. It's EBA 101 Boxing, and today we have a special guest, and we're gonna have introduction of Kalia Cortroni. If you can just tell me a little bit about your boxing record, where are you at, what is it right now at the moment?
Hi, I'm Kalia Cortroni, aka Pink Tyson, the Spartana Princess. I am original Spartana. My boxing record is 14-2 for KOs. I am world champion in WIBF and GBU federations, and I take the WBC international belt, and I have K1 record, 50 fights, 49 wins. I have wrestling, Brazilian, everything, but I think we focus today more in the boxing. But I can tell you, this year I do MMA and bark knocking the boot.
Okay. Well, actually, we could touch on both of them, right? Because I think this touches on the topic that recently, like Clarissa Shields, right? She's went into like an MMA fight. And if you could talk a little bit about the differences between preparing for MMA fight or some type of like that compared to a boxing, how is it different for you when you're preparing for it?
Do you know? It's completely different. Mm-hmm. I mean, of course, congratulations to Clarissa. But because she win, that not means it's the right way. Some boxers just with 7 months training go for MMA. Mm-hmm. Because the MMA is completely different sport. I do martial arts, and as I told you, I was K1 world champion. I am national wrestling, grappling, Brazilian champion. But again, to come all that together, I will do this year my MMA debut. Mm-hmm. Because this is the right thing. Of course, I tell you, congratulations, Clarissa, or anyone other boxer, they want to change. But for me, it's more serious job that. I mean, you cannot just box all your life and in 7 months you prepare yourself in MMA. Mm-hmm. Because she get now the win, that not means the next fight or the other fight will be the same. Mm-hmm. Because it's not about the win. Hopefully the girl, she doesn't injury Clarissa, but the biggest percent was mistake in 7 months to do MMA training and debut, by my opinion, of course. Mm-hmm. But
yeah, and she was honest about it, I think, in the live stream. Like, you know, you guys, I think the fans sometimes make it bigger than what it is, right? And the fans like, oh yeah, you can beat Amanda Nunes, oh, you when you'll be ready. And she's like, no, I need to do more training. And you know, like, and Nunes shouldn't be even in a mention with me, because she's onto bigger and better things right now. I'm barely new, I'm learning this, right? So it is an interesting thing. But yeah, from going from like K1, you said, what made you to go into boxing, or do you have a different type of love for each sport?
Do you know, I grew up in Sparta, and for us, the boxing, the kickboxing, the wrestling is our lifestyle. For me, from little girl, I do everything and more. I was trained more in boxing. Just in my country, we didn't have the professional boxing. Mm-hmm. And it was more easy for me to keep busy myself with kickboxing professional fights. Mm-hmm. But always at the same time, I was amateur as a boxer. I was in national team. But at the same time, to can earn some money, I did kickboxing fights. For me, it was not so big difference, because always my priority was the boxing.
Okay. So for you, you find it easier and more enjoyable to do boxing? Is it more interesting to do the K1? What's your preference, or you just like both and that's why you ended up doing both?
I like to do everything in combat sports, but my biggest goals are in boxing.
Okay.
All right. I mean, so I do my cycling in kickboxing. I take the world championship in USA 2012, But if something come now with very good proposal, I take it. But I cannot hand it that, if that makes sense. But about boxing, every day I look, oh, what next? What when I fight? You know, mm-hmm. I like the big challenges.
Okay. So when was your most recent fight? And what when is your next fight that you're looking to in boxing? And then if you want also your other MMA debut and stuff.
Yes, I did 27 March. The boxing fight, my last boxing fight for the WBC, the national. And the plan was to do my debut in May in Barkhnakhla. But approved my visa, but because the COVID, it's a little complicated to go mm-hmm. in the USA embassy to do my last paper things. For that reason, I canceled my Barkhnakhla debut on May. And now I train hard and I wait my manager to inform me when I fight for the WBC silver world title. As the WBC, I'm the number 8 in the WBC rankings. At the WBC, after my last performance, he wants I challenge the WBC silver world title. But for now, I can tell you 10 July, I take a part in the national tournament in freestyle wrestling in my country.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm very nervous. For me, maybe it's amateur, but means a lot of me because my dad was world champion in this. And I want to make proud him about that. But at the same time, I work very hard my boxing skills. And I wait to update me, my manager, when I go in Mexico, because we talk about Mexico or Spain, but possibly in Mexico, I come to fight for the silver world title. But all that will be before September.
Before September. Okay, so right now it's not lined up, but that's the target date where you're probably hoping to fight someone. Is there someone who holds it? Is it going to be vacant for the silver belt?
Look, as I told you, the WBC, after my last performance,
mm-hmm.
choose me and give me that opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
And the same will do about the opponent. Me and the girl will be both opponents. I mean, I don't think both will be the home or will be for the both challenge. And for sure, some names, I know already 3-4 names, they are opponents fire. You can understand, will be for world title. Me, I'm not easy opponent, and for sure will be easy opponent, and for me, the other girl.
Mm-hmm.
Will be very good girls to challenge that belt.
So with you being like the jack of all trades, right? Because you're in wrestling, you're done this K-1, you're doing these debuts everywhere. Like, what is your goal of like having that rest period between each sport
boxing.
Or each fight?
Boxing.
Yeah, boxing.
I want to be the best in my division first.
Mm-hmm.
And after, as I am multi-weight boxer, I want to go up and down and I challenge the best girls.
Okay.
I don't like just to stay safe in my division. I like to go in the bigger girls. If I have it again proposal with Clarissa Shields, for example,
mm-hmm.
I will take it. I will love that fight. If you tell me to go more down for other girls, I will go. Just to be good challenge.
Awesome. And that's the mentality that I was like, is that where, when you say the pink Spartan or what, you know, you're from Sparta. So is that mentality comes from that culture or where does that mentality kind of you feel like you got it from?
Of course, my country as a Greek, but more my place as Spartana.
Mm-hmm.
We grow up, it's we go get them as we have the term, understand? I mean, mm-hmm. we are warriors. Do you know the 300, only 300, they challenge in Thermopylae with King Leonidas, the millions or that in the person Thermopylae. I mean, we are in our blood. We go there. We don't care who is, what is. Just, you know, give me 5 date, kilos, that's it. I don't care who is. I don't care. I don't like to be paper champ. Just to have nicely wow records. I don't care if I lose or win, but I go there and I be like a lioness, you know?
Yeah, and I love that mentality, right? Because as boxing fans, and even with that mentality, right? A boxing fan sometimes are hard to please because if you beat someone that's really good, well, they're on to the next one, right? But the mentality of a true boxing fan is having that person that wants to challenge themselves and have hard fights. And like you said it perfectly yourself, not be a paper champ. You know, not with having four belts or like, I don't know, in women's.
Yes, unfortunately, the biggest percent in boxing, the managers, the promoters, some boxers, they destroy that beautiful sport. Because they look the business side. They forget the champion's mentality. And all they care, the athletes or some athletes to have nice records. But they cannot understand this is not our sport. Our sport is we bleed, we sweat, we fight. Understand, it's not a nice ballet. You pay a ticket and you see some dancers to dance. You must see a war. You must that you pay, you must get it. And unfortunately, in the women's boxing, all the time I see women's boxers or many people, they complain not enough money. But that you give, that you fucking take. Because you protect the girls, you fix the nice records, you buy the vacant belts, and that's it. Understand? It's very easy, everything.
Mm-hmm.
In the men's, are more difficult, everything.
Yeah. And you make a good point, right? At the end of the day, sometimes, and it's different for everybody, but making those hard fights, when you make those hard fights, people are going to come to see, like, it's like, if you have a good, entertaining fight, a lot of people are going to come and watch it, right? So there's people right now like Clarissa Shields, Katie Taylor that are making a little bit more attraction, bringing people because they're doing great things, right? And if you do great things, people are going to start watching you, and they're really going to enjoy that fight, and then it's going to be a really entertaining fight, and you're not just fighting easy fights,
but
people are going to watch it.
But again, the great things to do someone can't do alone. Someone, if I want to do great things, unfortunately, I cannot do by myself. Mm-hmm. I mean, you need a promoter, you need a manager, you need a country. For example, you tell about Taylor, of course, she's a very good talent, but Ireland covered her back, Matchroom Edihan covered her back, and with her talent, of course, she can do the great things. But if it was one other girl, like my country, we don't have professional boxing at all. We don't have a promoter. We don't have this. It's more hard. And if I born to do the great things, how I do the great things without the support back of me? Understand what I mean?
Yeah.
You need all the package. Yeah. Some girls, of course, they have the talent, but they haven't the package to can do more easy the great things. For example, me, to can call now myself WBC, the national champion, I go in Mexico with Mexican opponent, with fanatic people there, to scared if I go by points, if they cheat me, because I was the underdog. But I did it. Of course I was scared. Of course my manager W thought we take that fight. Not because don't trust me. Understand what I mean? But unfortunately, it's the boxing fucking system. You go other country and you go by points. It's more easy, you know. And if it's women's boxing and it's not covered by ESPN or this or that, it's more easy to cheat you, you know. For that reason, how you do the great things if you don't have people to make better the things?
Yeah, it's easier to be a go to the end of the line when you have an easy road compared to a bumpy road, right? And sometimes people have to go through that bumpy road to achieve the same things as someone who had a clean straight line to get there, right?
It's very difficult, but do you know, if you see the biggest boxers, right, the history wasn't easy for them. Look the story of Roberto Duran. Look the story of Muhammad Ali. The people to realize legends and real they are there for years and years and years is because was for the hard way. I tell you, I have repeated that again. My grandfather, because many times I cried, I tell, why is he do that? Why is he? And me, I can't do that, you know. And tell me, my grandfather, it's very easy to go in the top and very easy to go down off the top again. The more difficult is when you go in the top to stay. I know many boxers, they be world champions, they be in the top, they keep busy for some years, and after you don't remember their name. But some other boxers like Muhammad Ali, like Roberto Duran, like Mike Tyson, like Holyfield, like that people, you see they have retired, some other they have died, and still now we talk about them. Because when they get in the top, they do with a hard way, they stay. And it was not only the brilliant records, undefeated, they have beat, and Muhammad Ali has lost, and Tyson has lost, and so what? But they take the big challenges, and it was not easy for them. If you read their biography, it wasn't easy.
And it's interesting you bring these legends in, and I think a lot of people will know a little bit more of the story of Muhammad Ali, the struggles he went through with all the government and the civil rights movements and things like that. But like even Roberto Duran, right? He had a streak of winning. And then he saw Sugar Ray Leonard gain all this praise. And that's why I think he carried so much anger towards him, because it was like, look at me, I have so many years of being undefeated and, you know, being probably one of the best lightweights of all time. But this, a medalist comes in and it gets all the praise and all the money. Where's my hard work? Where's my rewards, right? And then, you know, that's why he ended up going up that weight class. And like you said, that gives you the example of like someone who's going through a harder road than to come up
with
an easier road.
It's crazy because me, I do for 2014, for example, and to challenge international belt WBC, it's after so many years. And now that I challenge silver, the world belt, after many years, and you see other girls, in 1 year, bam, bam, they be disputing world champions, like Taylor, for example. Of course, I tell you, it's a talent. But Eddie Hearn bring her champion, that belt, bam, 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 bam. Understand what I mean? The money do everything more easier.
Yeah.
Of course, in the life, but especially in the boxing business, it's a dirty game. Why I love that? I don't know. I love with my heart, and I try to keep my romantic side. I am romantic with the sport. That's what I mean. I love the sport, not for the money. I like the sport because I grown up as a warrior. I grown up as a fighter. If the money come, okay, nice. But if no, I don't care. You know, I want to beat the girls. And they don't use you as an opponent. How I be, for example, in two divisions world champion, how I be? If the world champions, they don't challenge me. Or if I don't have a promoter, big promoter, to pay them to come in my venue to challenge me, understand what I mean? Why someone to give me that opportunity?
Yeah, and then, yeah, if those opportunities don't come, Mauro Hagler had so many years before he was able to get a belt, right? It's hard to be able to get that world exposure when you don't have the things that the belt provides, is that you're in national television, the people get to know you.
Exactly,
right?
Yeah. Exactly. My country, we don't have that. I was in national team, for example. I wanted to prepare myself for Olympics, and we have the economic crisis. Hopefully, one Germany manager see me in one tournament, Aiba. He offered me to be managed professional. I didn't have a choice. No one of my country go Olympics. No one of my country, we have professional boxing to stay there. Some good talents, we go around the world. I mean, the wrong start of there. The most countries, they don't support athletes. Understand what I mean? After, how I go there, only if they use me. Come in Mexico, okay, I come. Come in there, I come. Two loss I have. And again, because she was like this, I go there. But what I do? I need to fight. I cannot fight in Greece because we don't have professional boxing. And that, unfortunately, I go to fight everywhere. Anyone. I just know what I mean.
But also that creates this mentality, right? I would think so, right? That it doesn't matter where you're fighting, you're going to have that mentality and prepare, because there's some people who only like to fight in their country, in their, you know, venues, and they never go outside, right? And a lot of people might say, like, Mexico have some of their people who only want to fight there. There's Europe people that only want to fight in Europe, right? But you're already being groomed to fight.
Everywhere. Yes, I fight all the world. But just sometimes I feel sad more because, you know, like before you tell, for example, of course I don't blame you. You tell, for example, Clarissa Shields or Taylor, they do great things. Yes, they do great things. But, and I can do how I do, understand what I mean. And other girls or boys, they can do. But it's more complicated in this sport. It's not just a run. You go in a running sport and who go forward, understand? It's not just a run. Needs more things. I know many, many talents, boys or girls. They can beat easy the big champions. But they don't have the right team around them. Because in the right team, cost. I mean, in 11 years I am boxer, I have some good coaches, but the most of times I do alone trainings. Because when you go in one very good coach, a big name, for example, he needs a money, he needs a percent. But how you give him the big money or the big percent? If you don't earn that big money, the most of boxers, they work, understand? Or we're struggling, or it's about the tickets, you know? For that reason, you tell Kale, okay, do a loan and keep a little money you will earn. Because never you can pay that good coach. Understand what I mean? But when other girl, like the names you told before, they have the very good coach. They have the very good promoter. They have the very good trainer, the very good catman, for example, the good car, the good prepare meals, the good supplements, the good that. If they are very good, they'd be great. But someone to be just good or very good cannot be great because don't have all the other things.
And I think that carries into a lot of like boxing is a poor man's sport, right? At the end of the day, as I started, right? A lot of people started fighting because they needed the money and the struggle. That some of the biggest boxers that have made it, they came from low income because they have that will and grit, right? And they might not have had all that support at one point, meaning sometimes the greater the struggle, the greater reward when you're able to overcome this issue.
You must write me that after.
Yeah.
You must text me. It's good that I like to write me.
Yes, I will definitely do. But that, I hope for that for you, right? And then also that's why, you know, I'm a small YouTuber channel. But I'm trying to grow it. I'm trying to support also female boxing in general, lower people that might not be known yet. And so that, you know, is having eyes on them. So they start watching their fights, trying to follow their careers, get to know them, because I feel like when people start to get you, to know you as a person, they're more willing to support you constantly and follow you, know, win or lose. That's my mentality, right? And I'm not, yes, I'm Mexican, Mexican-American, but I support, you know, boxing in general. And if I like a person, I like a boxing style, I will support them no matter what the race or background comes from, right?
But do you know the television or the social that, of course, is very big help, but at the same time, it's a bad promoting. What I mean, I see some girls, for example, or boys, I tell you for girls, as I represent the women boxing, because they fight in TV and they lost, for example, but because it was in the TV and they get publicity, they use that publicity to their own reasons to promote the boxing. Understand what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Because you are in TV, give you a big promoting, but that not means you promote quality, mm-hmm, as a boxer or as a person. And the people, unfortunately, when they are not real boxing fans, they have misunderstood what is the fucking the woman boxing thing exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Because some people, they represent that or promote that with the wrong way, because they get that big step off the TV. Understand what I mean?
Yeah, and the first boxer that comes to mind is a male boxer. I personally don't like him, but he's always like named a bunch of times, even though he's lost several times already. Adrian Broner, right? Adrian Broner, he lost all his big fights, and everybody was still wanted to find him because he brought in names. And at the end of the day, he wasn't throwing a lot of shots. He wasn't looking good in some of those losses anymore. But the people still came to watch him, right? And it was sort of like there's a lot of other boxers that could be given an opportunity. There are probably better boxers at this moment, you know, than him. But he's still getting paid like way more than some of the other boxers.
That I tell you, unfortunately, the television, if you are good, he make you brilliant. Mm-hmm. If you are set again, because he give you the step, we adopt the wrong fans for the wrong reasons. You see, for example, I don't want to waste at all more than seconds that I told you. You see that clone, Jake Paul,
mm-hmm,
and has more money, more followers, more everything than real fighters to try to do like Canelo, for example, mm-hmm, many years. And that a piece of shit, he tell represent the boxing, and other sets, the fans, they pay to see him. And after I tell, what the fuck, where I will fucking go as a boxing sport, mm-hmm, at the sun? Because what happened? All they look the money pocket. If the promoters or where he fight? No ESPN. What is that channel? I forget. Okay. Showtime or that. Because they look at the fucking money, they don't sell the quality. You know?
Mm-hmm.
I tell you something to understand what I mean. Reyes sponsor, mm-hmm, me. Reyes has specific design, the classic design. Never you will see Reyes, because I fight, for example, with the pink things and Barbie things, to design me pink Reyes gloves, Barbie.
Mm-hmm.
They try to keep their traditionality from the Mexico,
mm-hmm,
the classic and the quality. I tell you that comparison with the gloves, because some people, they keep the romantic in the sport.
Mm-hmm.
They don't sell what they represent. And for example, Reyes represent Mexico in the boxing, the quality, the fighters. They cannot paint clones and Barbie, Hello Kitty or anything. Not because she's mistake, because they try to keep the quality. Understand what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
We need in the boxing sport people to be more romantic and keep the quality in everything. Because now, for the money, some women, without being at all good, they sell their rematches, mm-hmm. they're good looking, and they think this is the right thing to promote the women's boxing. No.
Mm-hmm.
You need a total power cut, of course,
mm-hmm.
but you must show that you represent has quality.
Yeah, it comes, it's interesting because, you know, when it comes like, yeah, I notice a lot of female boxers, they're posting, or MMA fighters as well, you know, the selfies, and everybody has their own style, right? Sometimes if they want to do that, that's great. But that shouldn't be the only reason that this person is selling or becoming popular, right? It's almost like Oscar De La Hoya, when he came in, he brought a lot of female fans because he was good looking, but he also was winning championships and he was looking good in the ring. So he was like a little bit of the whole package. And I feel like that should be same for the females, right? Yeah, if they look good, great. But if they have to also be able to fight and be able to earn those big names, big fights, big
you
money.
Need the total package, yes. Yeah. But the biggest percent you must show to your fans is your boxing skills.
Mm-hmm. Number one.
I cannot tell. Of course, they tell me, for example, they tell me, I look very pretty for boxing.
Mm-hmm.
They told me that. But I don't go around my beauty to represent the boxing. That's what I mean. Of course, my beauty would be nice when I give one interview,
mm-hmm.
when I do one nice waiting. That's it. But I cannot let people know me for my beauty or my body or my teddy bears. That's mm-hmm. what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
The people, they know me for the fights, the record, the belts I take it. If I win or lose, no matter how I box, you cannot be around because you are a cute, beautiful girl. All the time you show your body, you show this, you show that. This is cheaply. This is not quality.
Mm-hmm.
But many, the attractive fans with that way. And I tell after, okay, for one boxer, she too good. If they are stupid and they follow or they buy tickets for her, she can do it. That's what I mean.
And
I don't blame. I don't blame her or him or anyone.
Yeah.
If they act the celebrities,
mm-hmm.
but that not means is the right for the sport.
And it's interesting because as athletes, right, we often fans criticize you guys in so many ways. But let's like sometimes that we were talking about that quality of bringing back to boxing. That also means bring quality of boxing fans, right?
Of course,
you know, understand boxing and like boxing for all different types of boxing too, right?
Of course, you cannot focus more what I wear, mm-hmm. how be my body. Understand what I mean? Than mm-hmm. how I fight, or you don't know shit what is the boxing fight. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
And you go to buy pay per views because Kalas wear a nice short skirt pink. Or Kalas has a big ass, for example. That's what I mean. This mm-hmm. is the wrong reason to buy the pay-per-view. That, me, as a Kalas, I don't want that fans. I prefer don't follow me anyone. I prefer tell me I have bad attitude.
Mm-hmm.
I prefer to don't shine never with promotion. I want quality, understand?
Mm-hmm.
Because for me, boxing is like religion. It's something more than the championships, than the money, than the bullshit, all that. Mia has sweat a lot for that thing. And I don't allow myself or someone to buy a ticket or that for the wrong reasons.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's been 35 minutes. I don't want to take too much of your time, but anything else that you want to promote for yourself, your social media, anything, or any other topic that you want to bring up to the fans, so they could, get to know you a little bit better before I let you go.
To know me better. Just I want to be a good person, you know. The championship, they have expired dates. One day you stop to be champion or box. I want to improve every day myself as a person. I want to try to help people. And if with the boxing be more famous, more rich, and that give me more power to can help people, that I want to do.
And that's a great message. I myself, I'm a mental health counselor, so I love to help people and try and make them better. And for for you to say things like that, like, yes, boxing is important, but then there's a life after boxing, right? There's
Yeah,
a good person then you need to be, no matter if you're like famous or not. Like the person and the quality of the person is very important, and I'm glad to that you get to say something like that, because not a lot of people will really think about it. They're always so focused on making it into boxing, 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 and I'm gonna be famous, and that's kind of what all they care about, and they forget about, hey, you know what? After boxing, I still want to be remembered as a good person.
yes, and I want to be good human being, and I help the other human beings. Because I tell you, it's no matter what title you have, what right your ID, what rights, what you represent, you are still human being. What color you are, no matters, you are human being. What job you do, no matters, you are human being. Understand what age, what skin you have, what everything, you are human being. And I want to stay there. No matters anything else, understand?
And that's great. So for me, and I wish you the best in your career. I really do. I will try to follow it as much as I can. And if you ever want to come in and again and promote your fights, or talk about your hopefully future victories, right? I hope you come back to my channel.
Of course, I come back. You are very good. You love that you do. And we need people like you to promote the boxing with a nice way. And thank you today to invite me. I enjoy our conversation. And for sure, we do it again.
All right. Remember to follow Pink Tyson, the Spartan Princess. I follow you on Twitter. Maybe I think there's an Instagram that you have.
Yeah.
Follow her fights, and also like and subscribe this to this channel. All right.
Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Thank you. Bye.